Hey folks, this is BestInSlot, and in tonight's Jurassic World Evolution 2 discussion video, we're going to talk about miniature exhibits, small, self-contained aviaries or terrariums or aquariums housing various different species. Yes, you're looking at Planet Zoo, it's because I'm going to use it as an example. Now, before we get into that, a little bit later on, I will show you how to build a working miniature exhibit in Jurassic World Evolution 2 with like a glass wall and everything. It is a modded only thing for now, unfortunately, but we'll keep an eye out. Maybe we can figure out how to do it unmodded eventually down the line. But for now, it's modded only and still pretty limited even for mods, but it's a lot of fun. And even if you're not going to use it yourself, I think it's pretty interesting to see it come to life. So show you that a little bit later on. For now, we're going to hang around in Planet Zoo because Planet Zoo, another Frontier game by the same company, already has miniature exhibits. Now, as I say, I think these are a really good way to expand on your building options, your decoration options and stuff like that when designing your parks. But more than that, I think they're a really cool way to expand on your species variety in your parks. Let's say you want to add something a little bit different. You want to add a Beelzebufo to your Evolution 2 park. That's not something I think would ever really fit in Evolution 2 as it exists. Not only do we not really have amphibious capabilities in the game, but it's so small it'd be a bit awkward, and you'd have to design a whole new sort of froggy toady sort of rig, and the animations would be awkward. It's a lot of work for something that doesn't necessarily fit with the franchise as established. Now, Evolution and Camp Cretaceous in particular has started to push us in a non-dinosaur, you know, we've had Smilodon in the franchise officially, so the potential for non-dinosaur creatures just keeps going up and up in this franchise, and I think that's a really cool thing, and I'd love to see it explored further in Evolution 2. So things like Beelzebufo, for example, even prehistoric insects, you know, Meganeura, Arthropleura would be a really good fit for mini exhibits. Imagine these mini exhibits, like here, like in Planet Zoo, limited, we'll talk about that in a second, but imagine them from Planet Zoo, but with prehistoric insects and prehistoric amphibians and, you know, maybe small microraptors and archaeopteryxes, blah, 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 and archaeopteryxes like we've got in Prehistoric Kingdoms, stuff like that. It could be a lot of fun. And I think realistically, that's the only way we're ever going to get creatures like that in Evolution 2. Now, for those who don't know, the way these work in Planet Zoo is you place down a single block like this, and you've got loads of different options. If we click this one here for our Goliath frog, we can change the layout. We can add, you know, logs like you see here on the lower right. We can change the climate, we can customize the walls and stuff like that. They're actually quite developed. Now, you wouldn't expect this for Evolution 2. I'd expect you place a building, you place the block, and you choose an animal, and that's maybe it. Maybe a couple little edits, but you wouldn't expect climate control and stuff like that. But that's okay. This is just a way to expand the species roster in, once it's developed, a much easier way for Frontier. Because if we hop into here, for example, and we look at Throg down here, our Goliath frog, he's just chilling in the corner. So how this works, for those of you who've never played Planet Zoo, is you place your thing down, you send your animals over, they populate the little glass thing, but they don't have AI. They sit there on a looped animation. So Throg, if I just sit here, I can sit here for 7 hours. Don't know why seven. I can sit here for 47 hours. And I can stare at Throg, and Throg wouldn't do anything that he's not doing right now. He's going to play the same looped animation over and over again. He's going to blink, he's going to nam nam a little bit, he's going to live his best life. So in a way, they're not that exciting if you just want to stare at your animals, right? It's more like expanding the species roster. But the more important thing is that they do move around-ish. So, you know, they'll be doing different things. Sometimes they'll be snapping at a fly, maybe going for a little swim, depending on where they've landed in the habitat. Now, if I left for a while, it would have to be a little while. We'd have to go off and do other things. But we came back later on. Actually, I might force this to happen. I'm going to do it. So basically, we're going to leave, and we're going to come back, and I'll show you what I mean. But returning, and yeah, as you can see, Throg is no longer there. So basically what happens is, as you leave, as you go off and do other things, your animals will move to different positions within the same little exhibit. And in those positions, they're just, again, going to play looped animations. But somewhere in... Oh, there he is. There's Throg sitting there at the back. So you see he's sitting on like a little log thing. He's blinking and doing basically the same animation, but he's doing it in a different location. And other ones will do different animations. You know, some of the water ones will end up swimming around. I can't remember what's in here. I think it's a crested newt in here somewhere. Yeah, there's a crested newt sitting down there. If I leave and come back, he'll, you know, be somewhere else in the habitat. So whilst they do play looped animations, they don't have AI. Whilst that's a negative to an extent, they're not, you know, super exciting in and of themselves. I say they expand the species roster greatly. And the important thing is it makes them a lot easier to add. You don't need to do AI. You don't need to do tons of new animations. You don't need to do social interactions. You don't need to do hunting animations. You don't need to do human kill animations. You don't need to do all the different feeding animations. You can add these really fun, unique creatures to your game without having to do a ton of work. Once the initial mechanic has been established, they're quite an easy thing to add. I mean, very difficult, you know, incredible skill involved in making them, don't get me wrong, but relative to the amount of work like a normal dinosaur would take. Now, people will differ on this, but I personally would very happily pay for a DLC that introduced 5 or 6 of these to the game. I wouldn't want them to replace a normal dinosaur, of course, but if they came out with little packs, or if they even came out in a free update, you know, I think this would be a lot of fun. So, here we are, Evolution 2 and Horror Park. What I want to know from you folks at home is, what species would you want to see? Would you like this as a mechanic? I think people would be, you know, I think when we saw it with Planet Zoo for the first time, people were a little disappointed in how limited they are, but I think we now just view it as a good way to check out those animals in really nice detail, and I think in that respect it works really well, and obviously it fills your park with new things. I think one of the problems Evolution 2 has, and Evolution 1 definitely had, Evolution 2 is a million times better at it, don't get me wrong, is that you can build a park, you can fill it with tons of stuff, but you're not really filling it with tons of stuff. You know, the lagoons and the aviaries were absolutely helped in that regard, they were a big update, but everything else is buildings and exhibits, aviaries, lagoons. There isn't actually that much variety in stuff, it's kind of exhibits and then ways to view those exhibits, which again keeps getting better with the addition of the log thing, which we're about to use in just a moment. But I think, imagine, you know, having your main street sort of area and then having like a little area here with all these little, like a petting zoo, for example. You know, there's all these different things we could do to widen that regard. But mini exhibits, petting zoos could even work on the same mechanic I'm discussing here for mini exhibits, you know, like a set looping animation, like the petting zoo from Jurassic World with baby dinosaurs that were only present in the petting zoo, people interacting with them again on looping animations that maybe change when you come back. I think it's a cool mechanic that could work for a lot of things that we've been asking for in Evolution 2. And this should be pretty easy. I should be able to show you this pretty simply. I did do a little practice earlier on. Did it tell me how to do it? I had to figure it out myself. And as far as I can tell, I can only get this to work with the log viewing gallery. It doesn't seem to work with the dome viewing gallery, because I thought that would be a lot of fun to have that as a mini exhibit. But no, we have to build it with the log viewing gallery. So what we're going to do to kick things off, hello, Listrosaurus from my practice earlier. We're going to grab a couple of log viewing galleries. Like so, I'm gonna, actually it doesn't matter at this point in time, but I'm gonna rotate them around just so they look a little bit different. And we're just gonna kind of stick those together so they mesh pretty nicely, like so. Now you are gonna have a bit of a problem in that there's gonna be sort of glass in the middle that the dinosaurs are gonna walk through. Again, not really much we can do about that. And what we're gonna do to make this easier, we're gonna grab it with N using, again, card and XP toolbox. We're gonna hold B, we're gonna sink it into the ground until the pathway disappears like so. Gonna do the same with this one. Should have done this first, really. Boop. And then we're gonna again just join them together. So it's a little bit more complex than you'd think to make this work. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna grab a fence, and we're gonna grab very specifically the biosyn fence, which for some reason, oh, it was defaulted. Never mind, ignore me. We're gonna grab the biosyn fence, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kind of sketch out where I would want the creatures to be. So probably like there, you know, there's a little doorway over here, so we don't want it to go too far. There, to there, to there, to there. Something like that. We're now gonna delete these, let's get a full demolish. We're gonna delete these galleries. So it'd be nice, it'd be really cool if this worked without mods, you know? I think it's a really fun idea, and I think it's something that the game needs less than it ever has done in the past, right? Oh yeah, I should say. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go into decorations, we're gonna go to our fourth tab, and we're gonna grab some concrete barriers. I could not get this to work without the concrete barriers, but maybe it can, I don't know. Anyways, I'm just gonna line the fence. I'm just gonna, oh, stop that. I'm gonna line the fence with concrete barriers, like so. But it's getting harder and harder for Evolution 2 for me to say things that the game needs. There's still things on my list. We've talked about it before, and we tend to talk after every major update. You know, the number one thing on my list personally is the ability for pterosaurs to walk around rather than just stop and fly and stop and fly. Particularly things, I say, like the Quetzalcoatlus. I also think they need expanded food options. But as cool as that is, and as happy as I'd be to see that, I don't think it would change how I play the game very much, whereas I think something like mini exhibits would offer them a lot more options down the line, potential for more money in that regard, expand the lifespan of the game a little bit, you know, stuff like that. This is a little sloppy. Oh no, because that's the fence, that's why, because I'm a dummy, that's why. Let me just grab that. For that. Okay, we've done that. And you're going to view this, you're only going to see this from the front. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab these and individually we're just going to sink these into the ground so there's just like a little lip. Like so. I don't know if the lip is totally necessary, but I like to leave just a little one just in case. Now this will contain a dinosaur, or in this case a Listerosaurus, so it will stop them escaping. If you can find a way to get these close together in unmodded versions of the game as well. You can use most of the objects in this game as a makeshift wall. We talked about using rocks, something we did way back in Evolution 1. Now, we've got to remember, Evolution 1 did not have rocks when it first came out. You know, they had to be added post-update. So, you know, as much as I think this game still needs some stuff, it's a far cry from what Evolution 1 needed, to say the least. Now, what we can do now, actually, is get rid... Oh, actually, yeah, I've never thought to do this before. If I go to just fences, that's the only thing on. Good way to get rid of just the fences. A lot easier. Oh, that's big brain. So in theory, this will now contain our list. He just sneezed. That should, in theory, contain our Listerosaurus. I'm going to speed up time for a second. Watch this play. But that should keep our Listerosaurus in place. Walking, and contained. Very cool. So I'm going to grab a couple more. There's plenty of Listerosauruses just sort of dotted around from my experiments earlier. And what we're going to do now is... So we need to do that first. We need to lay out the thing first. And now what we can do is go grab our log things once again. And we can give this another go. I'd like to point out, by the way, so I saw this... There's Reddit thread, like apparently the YouTuber branch of this game was updated, right? The idea being that at some point they'll send the game out to people and we'll play the update and, you know, be able to show off some content. But people on the subreddit got really kind of nasty about it, honestly. It was a little bit shocking. Oh, YouTubers all going to pretend they don't have the update and stuff like that. Can I just show you right now, I do not have the update. Like, I haven't uninstalled anything. These are all the mods that I had last time around, as you can see. But I don't have anything new. I don't have anything different. People think that we just pretend we don't have the update, but we don't. We don't get the update nearly as early as people seem to think we do. I think once, before Evolution 2 came out, I was doing a little bit of speculation, even though I had the game. I did one video about lagoons, which I distinctly remember. So I'm just syncing these, by the way, back to where they were before. But other than that, we don't, like, randomly start speculating about stuff when we already have the update in hand. It's nonsense. People like to build people up into weird villainous roles that don't actually exist. But it is what it is. Yeah. I think it's... Okay, cool. So I'm going to line those up. I've made this back one. I really got that wrong, didn't I? How did I get that so wrong? I have no idea how I messed that up so badly. It is what it is. Let's just line those up nicely. Okay, so... That now works, in theory. So I'm going to hop in on my first-person view. And if we hop over here, there's our Listerosaurus. So if you kind of just... I mean, what you could... The problem is... So the reason we've done a double one, I was going to say what you could maybe do is move the concrete a little bit further forward to the middle, and I'm sure that's what people are thinking when they look at this. The problem with that is when the gap... When the fencing is really small, when the exhibit space is so small, when they're contained in like a tiny little space, they seem to just walk out. Which is why I've used the double, because, you know, logically you'd use a single, right? So you don't have this sort of wall in the middle that ruins things a little bit. But if you use a single, it just doesn't work for some reason. Like, I could not get it to work. They just kind of wandered out willy-nilly. Likewise, if I was using the viewing gallery, this one, which I thought, again, was a really fun idea to have them walking around in this bit. They just kept walking out. No matter what I did with this, they could escape, even though they were contained by... Even if I left the fence there, even if it was big enough, you know, they just kept walking out. So this does seem to be the only way it works. But I've got to say, I think that looks really good. Like, if you catch them in a moment like this, it looks like a little mini exhibit. It's really effective. And, you know, they're not leaving. They're just going to hang out in there. And you've got yourself a pretty sweet-looking mini exhibit. And the log looks really good. And you could do this with mini exhibits in Evolution 2. They wouldn't have to be the ones in Planet Zoo have to be customizable and you have to be able to add tons of stuff to them. That's obviously not a problem in Evolution 2 because we don't have that level of customizability, but that means Frontier can go a little crazier with their designs. You could build them into like a giant log like this, or you could build one that looks like a little, you know, if we go into our decorations, for example, you could build one that looks like the classic, you know, perfect. You know, just get rid of that bit, put a little mini exhibit in there, have the foliage and the roof, and you've got like a little habitat. What I'm wondering, if I grab one of those new walls that we've got from the recent DLC, well, the recent thing. Let me go for this one instead. Just grab this. I'm going to move this over. Where's that concrete barrier? I wonder if I... Now, I think they've probably walked through that. But hey, look at that! That's really good. See, you can mess around with this and do some really cool things. It is, of course, modded only, but doesn't that look great? That's really good. I like that a lot. Hey, look at that! Not bad. Not bad at all. Cool. So that's how you do it. Shout out again to Shroomcoaster. It was their original idea. I had to sort of reverse engineer it and figure out how to make it work, but it was very much their idea that I nabbed. Shout out to Cowdenic, their mod that allowed us to do this. Frontier for having miniature exhibits in the first place. You know, Prehistoric Kingdom have done it in a really cool way as well with the Archaeopteryx and Microraptor so far. I'm really excited to see how they expand on that mechanic. It's something I'd really like to see in this game, but maybe I'm alone in that. Let me know what you think in the comment section down. I'm really chuffed with this, by the way. I really want to do a park where we just do fun little things like this and a petting zoo and all that kind of jazz. Yeah, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Is this something you're going to try out on your own modded park builds? You can do it a little bit neater, I'm sure. And I'll see you lovely folks very, very soon. Hope you have a fantastic weekend. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Throw me a like down below. I think I said that already. I had to make sure. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.